didn't have enough capital, didn't have enough belief, felt uncertain, not enough certainty. Well, tell me something just for a second here. One of the first times I ever asked this question, I was actually speaking to a group called TED. I don't know if you're familiar. How many of you are familiar with TED? Technology, design, they have a big website now. How many know what TED is? If you don't, you should check them out. I got invited to speak in this group. And I have a friend named Quincy Jones, a pretty famous man in America. And he said, Tony, they want you to come speak at TED. I said, Quince. He said, I am so exhausted, my schedule's so full. He said, Tony, you'll love it. There's so many great speakers there. You'll love being there. So he convinces me to come. So I show up for this big TED speech. And the man who didn't start it, but bought TED, meets me as I come into the room and he goes, oh, the motivator. And I hate that term. I've never been a motivator. I think motivation's nice. It's like a warm bath. You should have a bath every day, or at least a shower. But that's not enough. Motivation is not enough. You need strategy. Let's look me here and say, lots of motivation, a lot of strategy. You're going to fail me. I'm a strategist, but I do believe in the importance of energy. And he says to me, he goes, listen, I heard young people jumping things. No jumping here. I don't have you jump to jump. What we're actually doing is changing your mind chemistry. When you rise up like this, it opens your diaphragm and it fires neurotransmitters in your brain to actually make you happy. Unless you do this, you go, this is bullshit, this is bullshit, this is bullshit. If you do one thing in your head, shiza, and the other in your body, it doesn't work. But if you do the same thing and they're both good, your whole body changes. How many follow what I'm talking about here? Say, ah. So, the woman speaking to me tells me, you have 18 minutes for your whole speech. I said, what? Like, the shortest thing I do is 4 days. He said, no, everyone here gets 18 minutes. Bono, singer, at 18 minutes he was speaking, we cut him off. Bill Clinton, we cut him off at 18 minutes. If you've been 1 minute over 18 minutes, we cut you off. We'll turn your microphone off. And then he introduces me. And the person before me was a brilliant woman teaching string theory in 18 minutes, which is one of the most complex subjects in the world. And the people in the audience are crossing their arms, shaking their head, going, this is bullshit. I think these people are messed up. So I thought, how do I get their attention? I did what I just did with you. It's the first time I did it. I said, how many of you in this room have ever failed to achieve an important goal or dream? And they all did not raise their hand. No one raised their hand. Now, the room was a dark, small room in those days, 500 people. But who was in the room? The founders of Google. Who was in the room? Founder of Apple, Steve Jobs. Billionaires. Nobody raised their hand. They're all silent. I said, I know you're out there. I can hear your hearts beating. Come on. Nobody has ever failed. I finally get like 3/4 of the room to say yes. So I said, tell me why you failed. And these were their answers, very similar to yours. They said, I didn't have enough time. I didn't have enough energy. We didn't have enough capital. We lacked the right technology. We lacked the right education. We didn't have enough research. We had terrible people. We had terrible management. And then in the darkness in front of me, the small room, really dark, I hear this voice say, I didn't have enough Supreme Court justices. And I look down and it's Vice President Al Gore. And the whole room, and you probably don't know American politics, but he ran for president after he was vice president against George Bush, and the vote was so close, it had to go to the Supreme Court if he lost. And so where I was speaking was in San Francisco, and it's a Democratic stronghold. People would support him. And so 90% of them stood up and clapped like crazy, as he said, I didn't have enough Supreme Court justices. I just sat and paused, and they stopped clapping. And then I looked directly at the president in the group and I said, that's one way to explain why you did not become president. But it's not the accurate or truthful one. And they didn't mute it. And I said, easy for me, I didn't run for president, but hear me out and see if I'm right or wrong. When I asked all of you right here in this room, what caused you to fail, you said, I didn't have the time, I didn't have the money, or I didn't have the right people, and all the same things they said, right? And so I said to them, all the things you told me you don't have are resources. You're telling me I fail because I didn't have the right or enough resources. Money is a resource. Time is a resource. Energy is a resource. Even if you said you're fearful, courage is a resource. So you're saying I didn't have the resources, and all of us in this room are smart enough to know that the resources are not what matters. What matters is resourcefulness. How many follow what I'm saying here? Say aye.
Aye.
See, if you're resourceful enough, you get the resources. One of the biggest mistakes I hear business people make is, you know, I don't have the money, I don't have the time, I don't have the right people, I don't know who to talk to. They tell you all the resources they don't have. But the ultimate human resource is human emotion. See, if you're creative enough, can you solve the problem? Yes or no? Yes or no? If you're determined enough, can you get to the problem? Yes or no? If you're committed enough, can you find the money? Even if you don't have the money, can you find it? Yes or no? So what you have to understand is human emotion is the ultimate resource. Human emotion is what starts